Hello everyone. Today in this video, we'll do only Bangladesh, which is pretty similar to that of Pakistan. So stay with me until then, okay? Now, Bangladesh was a part of Pakistan and was called East Pakistan from 1947 to 1971. All right, let's go back to the history. In 1947, when India got its independence, at that time, it was also partitioned. Two units of Pakistan were created, one to the western side of India and one to the eastern side of India. Now, East Pakistan is what is known as today's Bangladesh. These two units were culturally very different from each other. If we talk about politics of East Pakistan from 1947 to 1971, then East Pakistanis were treated as second class. It faced various discriminations under Pakistan rule that they struggled for independence. For example, majority of revenue were collected from East. Only one military regime from East and remaining all others were from West. In terms of language, Urdu was considered as state language, and this made the Bangladeshi people face problem since they used Bengali. All right, and in the as in the civil services, focus was mostly on West Pakistan, and administrative representation was also unfair. Now, the second reason was denial of office to Sheikh Mujib. Now, because of all these problems, Sheikh Mujib Rahman over here, he led a popular struggle against West Pakistani domination by demanding autonomy for the eastern region. Now, Mujib was the leader of Awami League who won the 1970 election of the then Pakistan. However, he was not only denied the office but was also put behind bars. And this further enraged the people of East Pakistan, and then they started to struggle to liberate the Bangladesh from Pakistan. Then there was refugee problem in India. Pakistan at that time was under General Yahya Khan. Okay, in the process to suppress the protests, thousands of people were killed, leading to huge migration into India. About 80 lakh people fled into India from East Pakistan, giving India a huge refugee problem. India's effort to persuade Pakistan to stop this massacre of people in East Pakistan also failed. So India supported the demand of freedom by the people of East Pakistan by extending financial and military support. Of course, Pakistan accused India of conspiracy to break it up. Finally, we have the full-scale war. Now, after months of diplomatic tension and military buildup, a full-scale war between India and Pakistan broke out in December 1971. Pakistani aircrafts attacked Punjab and Rajasthan while the army moved on to the Jammu and Kashmir front. India, of course, retaliated with an attack involving the Air Force, Navy, and the army on both the Western and the Eastern front. India made rapid progress in East Pakistan, and within 10 days, Indian army had surrounded Dhaka from three sides and Pakistan army had to surrender. All right. Now, Bangladesh as a free country, India declared a unilateral ceasefire. Sheikh Mujib was released and he became the first president of Bangladesh. All right. And Constitution of Bangladesh was drafted in 1974. So the first leader of Bangladesh was Sheikh Mujib. Sheikh Mujib ruled Bangladesh from 1972 to 1975. Although he protested for independence of Bangladesh from Pakistan, however, surprisingly, he amended the constitution that was drafted in 1974 from parliamentary to presidential form of government, and he also abolished all political parties except his party, that is Awami League. All right. Now, of course, this led to conflicts and tensions, and on top of that, the implementation of his promised political reforms were also slow, leading to criticism against him. So, in a dramatic and tragic development, he was killed along with all his family members and staff in a military uprising led by General Zia-ul-Rahman in August 1975. Now, General Zia-ul-Rahman, he took over Bangladesh leadership in 1975. Okay, he formed his own Bangladesh Nationalist Party. Under him, ban on political parties was lifted, and he also restored freedom of press and speech. However, in 1981, Zia was assassinated by dissident elements of military led by General H.M. Irshad, the same way he did against Sheikh Mujib. Now, General H.M. Irshad, as I mentioned earlier, he led a military coup in 1982 and took the administration from General Zia, giving the reason of corruption, ineffective government and economic mismanagement. He suspended constitution and declared martial law. All right. Now, this led to widespread people and especially student protests in favor of democracy. Here, the students played a very important role since they led this movement. He was forced to allow elected presidential and had to give up his power in 1990. And since then, Bangladesh is a multi-party democracy. Okay. Now, in the election of 1991, Khalida Zia won, and from 1991 till 2006, Khalida Zia and Sheikh Hasina ruled Bangladesh alternatively. Khalida Zia is a Bangladeshi politician who served as the Prime Minister of Bangladesh from 1991 to 1996 and again from 2001 to 2006. Now, she is the wife of Zia-ul-Rahman, if you remember him clearly, and she was the first woman in the country's history and second in the Muslim majority countries to head a democratic government as Prime Minister. Now, Sheikh Hasina, who ruled from 1996 till 2001, is the daughter of Sheikh Mujib here, the first president who was assassinated by Zia-ul-Rahman. Okay? Now, because of the growing political instability, widespread corruption and growing strife between BNP and the Awami League, emergency was imposed in 2007 and an interim government or a caretaker government was formed, which was led by military. Fakhruddin Ahmad was appointed as the chief advisor. So you can clearly see the government instability in Bangladesh. Election was then held in 2009, in which Sheikh Hasina of Awami League won. She is the 10th and the longest serving prime minister in the history of Bangladesh. Okay, so this is all about Bangladesh. Now, if you are like me who gets confused with the order of names, then here is what I've done. I've created a sentence in order to help me remember the names and the order. And the sentence is, Sir Zia hoped Khalida and Sheikh fight successfully. We'll go and by silence. S for Sheikh Mujib. Z for Zia-ul-Rahman. H.M. Irshad. K, Khalida Zia. S, Sheikh Hasina. F, Fakhruddin Ahmad. And S for Sheikh Hasina. Now, again, remembering their tenure. Now, that's a problem for me too. So I thought of an alternative. I found out that there is some commonality in all these leaders. So let's have some fun. Let's do a little calculation. We'll do a multiplication by three. Let's first write down all the names of the leaders in order. Let's put three for all the leaders. We'll leave Sheikh Hasina since she's the last and is serving president of Bangladesh. Then we'll put the multiplication sign next to the number 3. Now we'll write the numbers in order. However, after H.M. Irshad, since the two ladies' tenure is done together, we'll skip the 4th and put 5th instead of going 4th and 5th. Okay? Now let's do the calculation. And it's done. We have the years. We must, of course, remember the year 1972 when Sheikh Mujib started his office. So Sheikh Mujib has got 3 years. 1972 plus 3 is 1975. So his tenure is from 72 till 75. Likewise, the same applies to the others. Now, for the ladies, we know that they have ruled on alternative basis, right? Their calculation comes to 15. So we'll divide the 15 by 3 and we get the answer 5. There we go. Each of them ruled 5 years. I don't think Fakhruddin's year is important since his was a caretaker government. However, if you do want to remember his as well, then you can just remember that before him were two ladies. So he ruled 1 year, each for them. And that makes 2. And finally, we have Sheikh Hasina, which you definitely need to remember the date. So this is all about Bangladesh. I think you need to watch this clip a couple of times to remember the different regimes. However, I'm sure that you will get it. Should you have any questions, you can always WhatsApp me or call me. And until I upload my next video, you guys stay safe and take care. All right? Bye-bye.